On November 21, 2007, 29-year-old Kelly Forbes strangled her 50-year-old husband Michael Forbes to death with an electrical cord in their Long Island, New York home, claiming it was self-defense. She told investigators that on the night Michael was killed, he attacked her with an electrical cord, but she said she managed to wrestle it away from him and wrapped it around his neck after kneeing him in the groin. Kelly's defense painted her as a victim of domestic violence forced into a desperate act of self-defense. However, this narrative was complicated by revelations of her affair with Jeremy Bryant, a former flight attendant who testified at her trial. According to Jeremy's testimony, Kelly texted him a response to a series of questions he texted her that read, quote, "No, I did it," end quote. Jeremy also testified that Kelly called him crying after the text, and when he asked her what happened, she reportedly said that she and Michael had argued the night before and she blacked out. When she regained consciousness, Michael was dead. Despite Kelly's plea for mercy, she was convicted of first-degree manslaughter on August 19, 2008 and sentenced to 21 years in prison. On December 24, 2011, 40-year-old Karen Lynn Baraji murdered her husband Alan in their Spring Hill, Florida home. Their relationship began to sour after 10 years of marriage and they separated 3 weeks before Christmas. 31-year-old Alan had begun a romantic relationship with a co-worker and planned to move in with her after Christmas, which he discussed with Karen. Karen had also been sleeping with men she met online, including a neighbor up the street from their house. On Christmas Eve morning, Karen woke up and found Alan asleep on the couch around 5 a.m. She grabbed her recently purchased .38 caliber handgun, approached Alan as he slept, and shot him in the back of the head twice, killing him instantly. Following the shooting, she drove to her parents' house, returned with them, and then called 911 to confess her crime.
I'm sorry, I'm turning myself in for killing my husband.
Where's your husband?
He's on the couch right now.
Okay, is he alive?
No.
How did you do this? What did you do to him?
I shot him.
On March 28, 2013, Karen was sentenced to life in prison without the possibility of parole. On October 4th, 2022, 41-year-old Cocina Penn brutally murdered her husband, 56-year-old Robert Penn, outside their Paducah, Kentucky home. Robert's son, Carl Penn, was the one who called 911 saying, quote, "My dad is on the ground, he's just been stabbed," end quote. By the time EMS workers arrived, Robert was deceased and his organs were lying on top of his stomach and chest. Cocina told police that her and Robert had gone for a walk around 3 a.m. and upon returning home, an unknown assailant jumped out and attacked Robert. Doorbell video contradicted her story, showing Robert fleeing and pleading for his life, screaming, quote, baby no, end quote. The evidence showed Cocina as the attacker, and further investigation revealed she had been having an affair with a friend of Robert's named William Tabor. In the days prior to the murder, she had asked William if he knew anyone willing to kill Robert because she, quote, hated his fucking guts, end quote. When he stated he didn't, she took the matter into her own hands. Due to the video evidence and the testimony of William, Cocina Penn was found guilty of murder on December 14, 2023. Her sentencing is scheduled for January 24, 2024, where she faces 20 years to life. On June 7, 2011, 20-year-old Amber Hilberling pushed her 23-year-old husband Josh out of their 25th floor apartment window in Tulsa, Oklahoma. The couple had been married less than a year and were expecting their first child. They had been having an argument when a pushing match ensued, causing Amber to push Josh backwards out of the high-rise window before running downstairs to hold his lifeless body. Amber was arrested and charged with second-degree murder. She posted bail and gave birth to their son, Levi Carter, on August 6, 2011. During her trial in March 2013, a repairman testified that he heard arguing from the couple's apartment on the day Josh died. He recounted hearing a loud crash and a scream, followed by finding Amber standing next to a broken window. Amber allegedly said, quote, "My husband fell out the window. I pushed him. He's probably dead," end quote. This served as a crucial piece of testimony during the trial. Amber Hilberling was convicted of second-degree murder on March 18, 2013 and was sentenced to 25 years in prison. On October 24, 2016, Amber was found hanging in her cell from an apparent suicide. In January 2005, Staff Sergeant Michael Severance, a member of the United States Air Force, was murdered by his wife, Wendy Mae Davidson, in San Angelo, Texas. Michael's body was discovered in March 2005, submerged in a pond, poisoned with animal tranquilizers, and stabbed 41 times post-mortem to prevent the body from floating to the surface. The couple had planned to visit family in Maine in January 2005, but those plans were abruptly canceled when Wendy reported Michael missing. Investigations into Michael's disappearance soon revealed some troubling behavior by Wendy. Despite her initial claims of him leaving voluntarily, detectives found internet search histories on human decomposition, which raised suspicions. When Michael's body was discovered, it led to a deeper investigation that implicated Wendy in his murder, particularly the use of animal tranquilizers, which pointed directly to her involvement. She was a veterinarian who had access to those tranquilizers and tools that were used to stab Michael's body. To avoid a trial that could lead to a sentence ranging from 9 to 99 years, Wendy decided to plead no contest to first-degree murder. She was given a sentence of 25 years in prison with an additional 10 years for evidence tampering.